Hello, I'm Marc Molinari. I'm the course leader for electronic engineering and also for the degree apprenticeship scheme in embedded engineering. We're seeing the second year students today having a little robot race and robot test. So as part of their course in the second year, they are creating robots from system components, an Arduino microcontroller and a number of sensors. And ultimately they'll race these on a racetrack today and compare how well they're doing. Here students learn to combine Arduino microcontroller systems with infrared sensors, ultrasound sensors, and ultimately applications and programming these applications. Some of these applications, for example, are in hospitals where you have trolleys that can deliver medication to patients on different floors. We have a very good example here where students asked to program robots and use sensors to follow lines on the floor, but also avoid objects along the line. Students need to program all of these things. They need to take inputs into account as well as actuator outputs, the motors that drive the robot. They need to integrate two different types of sensor systems. An infrared sensor bar that has 8 sensors on it that determines where the robot is in relation to the line, and that picks up the contrast between the dark line and the lighter background. The second sensor is an ultrasound sensor which measures the distance in front of the robot. It sends out an ultrasound wave which gets reflected by objects. From the flight time we can calculate the distance, and from that distance then the algorithm can determine which way to turn, left, right. Sensor systems such as this are used in many applications, especially in the future in autonomous cars. Even now, when you park backwards into a parking space, you have ultrasound sensors that will tell you how far you are away from a wall or from a second car. It's really current technology that we're trying to teach. Robots don't always run perfectly the first time they're being tested. Students learn how to deal with issues and solve those problems. And as part of engineering, really, a third of engineering project time is testing time in a safe environment at the university. You can make mistakes, but ultimately you learn from those mistakes and hopefully not make them again.